Afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the webinar on exploitation of HPST oil well by hydrofracturing. I take this opportunity to welcome today's expert, Mr. N.K. Mitra. Sir has 47 years of experience in oil and gas industry, mainly in domain of subsea oil and gas drilling and completion, hydrofracturing of high temperature and high pressure oil and gas processing and pipeline design. Sir has worked with ONGC, Reliance Industries Limited, GSPC, and currently sir is working with SPE Mumbai. It is an honor and privilege for us to have you, sir, today. Now, I am handing over the session to you, sir. Welcome, sir. Please.
Yeah, basically, I am a hardcore production engineer. I was director and director marketing of ONGC. In my retirement, I joined as Reliance as President operation, looking after drilling and completion and technology. Then, after 4 years, I joined to GSPC for their difficult field, very tight fields were in offshore. So, from construction, design, laying pipeline, drilling. So, they had a huge problem. Before I joined, they have a failure of about 4 to 5 wells. In the well depth is about 5,200 meters. Temperature is about 415 degree Fahrenheit, bottom hole pressure is about 14,000 PSI. It is a very, very high temperature, high pressure well. Nobody has encountered at that point of time. Now, a lot of people has come up. Technology, mud, drilling equipment, logging equipment, perforation equipment, not available. So, after the failure, I took up and we slowly started doing this work, and because all the well has a stock up. About 4,200 meters stuck up because of differential sinking. So I tried to explore, and lastly I took help from British Petroleum. So our beloved Prime Minister talked with British Petroleum Chairman. So they help us. We have gone many times to their Houston and their field in Oman. So we saw their operation and we learned their technology, and their people are also working with me for some time. Now I start, what is hydrofracturing? Hydrofracturing is nothing but where the permeability is very low. Permeability is very low where oil cannot come up. The shale oil technology, they do every day something about 300 to 400 fracture in the USA per day. Now it is in, sometimes last to last year, it was almost 3,000 fracturing per day was going to happen there. Other than Schlumberger, Halliburton, Baker Hughes and Weatherford, there are many parties are there to doing that thing. Onshore hydrofracturing with shale gas is quite different than offshore hydrofracturing in offshore. So now I start my presentation with a small brief. We'll discuss here what is oil domain. Oil domain means at what temperature, pressure, different oils are categorized. Then petrophysical property of the reservoir, that is geophysical property. We'll discuss some amount. We discuss about reservoir porosity, permeability, and other some amount of details. That mini frac job is there. Then RFIT. Then we discuss SRD. So all these things help to identify the fracture design. Then perforation is a major subject. As a petroleum engineer, we do not have much knowledge. Though I was when I was in college days, we learned general evolution logging was one chapter was there. But when I gone to Houston in US, there was 17 expert came for only for perforation. 17 expert came for giving a lecture to perforation. Similarly, fracture fluid, so high temperature fracture fluid. There are oil based mud, there's water based mud, there's polymer, there's good gum is there. These are the fracturing fluid. Then selection of propane. So, propane, we have learned a lot of things. It should not get crushed in during fracturing process. So, what are the design challenges? Then, tubing design and well completion, whether what type of packer will be there, because it was H2S and CO2 was there in the well. Is a unique one, chrome tubing is required. And chrome tubing has a peculiar behavior. If you tight it, more the tight, the galling will be there. So thread will be, socket will be galled. When it will be mixed up with the tube, so you cannot open it up next time. Similarly, fracture design, we have to do mini fracture. So without putting the propane, we do a fracture so that we able to know the fracture, nature of fracture. From that, we don't put any propane in mini frac. From that, we stop fracturing and we produce some pressure data. Slowly, fall it assertive will happen. From that, we know the some permeability of the reservoir so that how much propane has to be pumped. Then some reservoir allocation factor interpretation like G function will be discussed, and then modeling will be discussed. Different ways of models will be there. How the famous modeler Beddy Associates has done it, and subsequently various types of models are there, which are some are useful for horizontal fractures, some are vertical fractures, some are used for long fractures, some are high thickness fractures. Then main problem is in India, the fracture problem is that flowback. During flowback, we should increase the choke 1/64 of an inch and wait for 6 to 10 hours. Then get stabilized. Otherwise, from the formation, will fracture get closed. Lot of particles, sand and other particles will come back. So it will slowly will increase the choke side and get stabilized this flow. So and we BSNW is going to monitor at that time. Then we in the mixed up case, so a lot of case study are there. So what you have done there here. So I have written a book on hydrofracturing this year. It was released by OGC Director Drilling in March in IIDC conference. So this is the domain. From the domain, you can see that one side temperature is, other side pressure gradient is there. So Deen Dayal field is coming and the most of the typical high temperature, high pressure domain, because pressure is 415 degree Fahrenheit and pressure is about more than 13,000 PSI pressure. So in the bottom graph, you can see there are different categories are there, temperature and pressure. So 10 kpi, 20 kpi, 30 kpi, 40 kpi, and the top domain is 600 degree Fahrenheit, 500 degree Fahrenheit. So the different field in the world and categorize it in this world here. So you can see from the graph in top right corner, top Deen Dayal field is there. So worst possible field is Fandango field is one of worst possible fields. It's very difficult to do it. Moreover, the problem was there in this is a small stack of reservoir there, about 13 to 14 layers are there, so they are very limited reservoir, pitch is changing very faster. It also boundary radius of the drainage radius, whatever say, you cannot go more than 800 to 850 meters, because then the permeability variation will be there, pinch out is there, then there may be stratigraphic variations will be there. So we have to do little bit of for economic study, little bit well performance, what has happened with the last well before fracture and after fracture, what has happened. So any drilling for high temperature, high pressure oil or deep water drilling, we have to carry out geomechanical analysis and stress profile of these rock where we have to drill, and we have to take core. There are different types of cores are there. One is cylindrical core, one is sidewall core. Because the geomechanical study, we able to know what is the pore pressure gradient, what is the fracture gradient, so that the moderate can be maintained. Moderate will be sub between the fracture gradient and pore pressure gradient. So the PPG moderate is decide on that one. So from this one, we can get some log, resistivity log, we can know what will be thickness of the formation, productive formation, maybe one sandstone, one limestone, but generally it happens sand and shale. So we should not venture upon to fracture a shale portion because we have targeted something here so that shales are brittle here. So fracturing of shale is a different process. So fracture initiation process, we have to find out that will come later. From the mini frac curve, we are able to tell you. So, for low breakdown pressure, we should have fracture closure pressure also to know. So limitation is difficulty is getting the representative core and the plan of time doing of hydrofracturing job. Because we have to do reduction of permeability test, we have to know the porosity also, we have to know saturation also. So sideward core and main bore core are little different because sidewall cores, when taking the sidewall core, sometimes it gets shattered. So we get a wrong reading. Sometimes induced permeability has come up. And the error in depth correlation also is there, because if the depth correlation is not more, so we do not know. That's why we have to do various logging also there. So there are opener logging is there, other logging data is LWD, logging while drilling. But nowadays, open hole logging is very less. Inclined well, open hole logging correlation is avoided. But it doesn't mean that we don't do it. But so, open hole logging versus cased hole logging, or cased hole logging versus LWD logging. So, we have to correlate it so that we can know it. But because in sidewall core, if the core not keep properly in the core house, so there is a chance of degradation, because if you lose core, if you not pack, core packing and storage process is different. So detailed petrophysical model based on this is drawn. Other than geophysical or geological model, basin study is required. Petrophysical model is required based on the petrophysical product, that is the resistivity, conductivity, SP log, resistivity log, NMRM log, then sound log. That is ultrasonic log, sonic log, you can say it. So these are the 4-5 major logs are there. So from that, you can some correlate it based on the reservoir data. Some reservoir data you get, you know, take the core and Raska porosimeter, we find out the porosity and permeability, and some amount of saturation you get it. There are two types of testing, and the one is air expansion and another the market ingestion. Market ingestion sometimes core get damaged. So fracture design goal, fracture height and length is optimization to know how much fracture should propagate. So this is we can find out from the mini frac. So fracture growth may be away from the pay zone in absence of stress barrier, or there is some water zone, so we should not frac that zone. So there is some safe zone also there. We frac it just like drilling a well, putting a mud, well is not returning back, that is because there is some safe zone is there, so it is getting lost somewhere. So technology has come up that safe zone is also during drilling process can be identified and can be stopped. Then propane placement. Propane placement, we can find out this, what will be the viscosity of the mud, at what temperature when mud will be there. Based on that, we get a comparative study of fracturing fluid. So fracturing fluid, we find out the viscosity, all also centristroke also at what temperature stability is there. Then when is this fracturing fluid put in the core, and we have to find out what will the retained permeability. So what permeability will be there after fracturing. Then we have to find out the pack conductivity of propane, that is gel breaking, propane crushing, propane gets crushed in the bed when the fracture gets closed. If it is a propane is stronger and bed is soft, propane gets stuck, or it can get embedded also. And in some cases, the propane is not strong enough, so it gets fine created and it gets clogged the fracture. Kh by mu is not is a basically flow capacity of the fracture of the well. So this is the orientation of fracture we are telling you. So multiple fracture can occur when you are perforating the interval. So formula is 4RWD dependent on angle theta. Sometimes fracture may be not happen in horizontally, because it rock when deposited in what the bed of tiltation is there due to river movement, because in the KG basin, the basically the rocks are reliance field levees and fans are there. Levees are fan, nothing that when we go to river delta, you see that from the bank, the sediment go on the top of the soil and get deposited, and that's the key to get better for porosity permeability. Better than the GSPC and ONGC field, they are deeper field, whereas D6 and Reliance, it is a shallow field. It is 800 to 1400 feet, and whereas GSPC field is about 4200 to 5000. But water depth towards GSPC was very low, because 1500 to 2000 is the one platform was there, or basically two platform was there. So ONGC is now developing 98/2. There will be about something about 40 to 45 wells will be there, some gas injection wells, some water injection wells, some producing wells. And they will be connected with the FPSO, then go to platform. This is the mode of operation that will go to liquid, will go to Reliance Kakinada onshore process facility. So there are how to know the orientation fracture. This is a full bore formation micro imaging, that is FMI logging or FMS logging. We can find out from the geomechanical study the wellbore breakdown pressure, micro seismic. In shale gas, we have to, all the well has to frack in a horizontal well. Maybe we have to frack about 10 to 12 zones. So to know the fracture has happened or nature of the frack, the micro seismic bands should be there. So sensor will be embedded in the soil, and they catch the seismic wave inside the one. From there, they interpreted it. Then structural geology should know from the orientation of the both the drawing. One is horizontal and another is vertical fracture. So hydraulic fracturing, so here theta H and D and theta H1M. So this is the orientation angle is there. Basically, you have to prefer the horizontal fracture plane and least stress bread plane. Those are the less pressure to be layered to initiate a fracture. So what is the entry hole diameter? Entry hole diameter, we should have industry practice 18 to average particle diameter. Minimum is 6 and safest is 10. 10 is very difficult to get. Generally, it happens between 6 to 7. Phasing means it is right corner bottom. You can see there is a 90 degree angle is there, about 60 or 120 degree angle is there. So generally, if it is happen 120 degree difference, is the most preferable one. And you can go also 90 degree angle, also four factor in a horizontal in a well bore, that is also desirable. But per hole, how many will go and what is the shot per feet, conventionally 6 shot per feet, 60 degree phasing, or whereas 120 degree, 3 shot per feet. The conventional efficiency of a open perforation versus barrels per minute is equal to, per perforation we should put, should design a thing for two barrels per minute, pumping with fluid and propane. So here in the, on the sea analysis, that different types of propane are there. Different size in sea analysis. 20 by 40 is the majority used, 20 by 40 C used here mostly. Because actually there is an area in the US where these propanes are used to get and used to do fracturing long back. Now all propanes are synthetic ones. So there are the glass beads also there. So here different names are there. When you come that area, I will explain you. So this is where he was talking about, it is hydroperforation. This is called hydroperforation that used to do. I remember it. I have done it in 1973 in Kalol field. Kalol field, we do not have this type of fracture orientation tool or FMI logging system. So with a sand jet, with a drill string or tubing, generally do not use tubing. We do some internal flash drill pipe, but it's a rixie. But the separate strings are there for fracturing for everybody. Okay, so separate strings are there. So, but here we can get hole doesn't get damaged. we get a bigger hole for putting more propane in the system. It is more safer, no explosives are used. Number of perforation damages at lower breakdown pressure. So basically you can do with a coil tubing. Coil tubing has some limitation, but coil tubing is a 1 inch and 1 by 1/4 when coil tubing starting from up to 2 inch coil tubing done for offshore, where the tubing is 5.5 inch. Onshore tubing side is 2, 7, 8, and 3.5 inch. When offshore tubing is generally 4.5 inch and 5 inch, even there is a field in Ormen Lange in North Sea North that they use 9.58 tubing also. Okay. Because each well produces about 10 million standard cubic meters per day. You cannot imagine it. There is a depth control is very difficult. What point of time you are making the hole, maybe 100 meters or 20 meters, but there will be difference, maybe 200, 2 to 3 meters, not more than that. Because due to temperature, some elongation of the string will be there. So generally, all the things done in the downhole compression, there is called CCL law, casing collar locator law, said to find the distance from the mean sea level, rotary table plus adding some depth, that is called mean sea level. From that, depth correlation is done, is there. So, but the hydro perforation is done, it takes long time as compared to when you are. What you do in what we had done in the past, and generally they had a perforation gun, they hang from the bottom, TCP, we call it a through tubing perforation. They hang from there. We place a rod from the top, and we go to bottom, and we puncture this explosive chamber and explode the TCPL, and they both the side of 180 degree orientation is there. They activate it and they fall down in the well. But only problem is sometimes when we do not know, or when we do selective one more zone, that is not desirable. Then we have to do different types of things. That will come later. So this is the TCP gun is assembling here. So through tubing perforation gun, it is hanged from the tubing bottom. It is a Schlumberger tool. So now come back to propane. The propane selection should be, it should not be embedded, it should not be crossed. In situ stress should be such that propane has a much more hardness. There are hardness scale is 1 to 10. So, diamond hardness is 10 and mica hardness is 1. Residual propane pack conductivity, you have to find it out. And propane crossing test in the lab, we have to find it out. This is the mechanical one. Then sieve analysis, the maximum retention at which grain size the sieve is there. Our distribution based on that multiplication is figure is there. Say multiplication figure is we decide the what will the propane size. The propane sporosity roundness is called a Kumban shape factor. Also, sometimes we find that if there is a during process of cleaning, that acid is there in the well or some tubing or somewhere, we're not cleaned properly. So we get some impurity of sand in the system. So we measure the TSS. It should be less than 0.5 milligram per liter. Within half an hour interval at 30 psi. It's a mini pore filter if you collect it. Propane crossing test for 10% permeability value, then apparent density of the propane, the bulk density of the propane. There is a triangular chart is there. Top of the propane is a ceramic propane. What is nowadays used very commonly is a high conductivity, a safer, properly maintained. Then one is resin coated, it is a medium one. And last one is sand coated, it is usually done in a long back. So, fat fluid have different properties there. So minimum viscosity from 100 centipoise during pumping process. So you have to add some viscosity reducing agent on the last of the fracturing process. Otherwise, you have to make the viscous such a way that propane doesn't get dropped out in the pumping process. So should be able to stay in the solution, doesn't get disintegrated. This is a synthetic polymers are there, or other chemicals are there, water based are there. They should not get lose their thixotropic property. So retain permeability are always test. It should be after putting into some type of pressure with a fracturing fluid in the core chamber. So we should see that permeability is retained the original, that more than 85%, but doesn't happen. There is a one test called clay stability. So clay stability, because monopyrroline clay may be there in very common in Gujarat. So capillary suction test is there. It is short duration test. Then breaker is used for irreversible breaking of the gel within a couple of hours for the main fracture. So generally the breakers are added in the frag end of the fracturing pumping process, so that in the whole what fracturing fluids are remaining in the air through CTU, so you can pump it back. Or it can come back during flowback period, when it's changing the choke in the surface and flowback period. So regain permeability is more than 50%, it is not desirable, but it is happened sometimes also. That is happened in our one of the well, first job that has happened. Some gentleman, is a slumberger, a highly button guy, say by mistake he has input in the system chemical more viscosity reducing agent. So there was a dropout of propane from the pumping solution, and the well got jammed. So we have to drill that one. So well got unsuccessful job, basically you can say. So breaker concentration should be well optimized. You have to, what breaker will use for viscosity breaking, that concentration should be limited. That should not be higher. Suppose we give 0.3 ppm breaker, we should not go for 0.4. So it measure properly. Our measurement failed that time because our mass flowmeter didn't work properly. So live breaker should be used in this stage of last fracturing stage. So these are the various fracturing fluid, Newtonian fluid. We are not talking non-Newtonian fluid or dilatin fluid also. Here is a cross-link polymer gels are there. Borate is one of the best thing used to use long back. Nowadays not much used. So organometallic cross-link fluid, gel oil system, surfactant gel, foam and emulsion, and breaker. Organometallic one is also used very frequently. So in between here, there is a gur and gum, Saracomar is there, that is how we have used it in GSPC, and nowadays ONGC has also used it. So these are the different organic structure. The gur gum is a no derivative, high molecular weight, and long chain sugar. Naturally, 6 to 10% residue is available. Residue should be low. Carbomethyl group, single derivative, is not really use it. Propylene oxide, hydroxypropylene group, and this is a single derivative. There's a 2 to 4% residue is there. Generally used it in a deeper well, because temperature stability is good there. This is not, cannot be ignored, this one. Carboxymethyl hydropropyl gur and gum. So these we have used it. Clean polymer, double derivative, and less residue is there. So structure, right hand side structure is explained it here. Is a close chain organic compound like benzene. Oh, this is the graph one side. They said from DST you can, or any well logging process where temperature sensor is there. We have to plot a geothermal gradient. It is a 0.4 or 0.3, 0.38, whatever that. So the gradient has to be plotted. So up to something around 4,500, 4,800, up to we have plotted here. That gives a 410 degree Fahrenheit. And other side, left side, the reservoir pressure is 12,500. Here, purple color one is basically pore pressure, and there is a green portion is here based on that casing policy is decided. We don't require any other casing policy here. But other side is another pressure is there. If the formation pressure is X, so X plus 0.7 is the mud PPG is 7. So another PPG divide it 0.7 plus 0.7 14. So around 12 will be the frac gradient. So in, we have to use our drilling fluid. All things should be between pore pressure and frac gradient. So here from the bow side, you can see the different casing depth profile. So this is the elliptical stress diagram. This is basically in between the ellipse. This is brush pressure, collar pressure, and compression pressure. So brush pressure generally happen on the bottom of the casing of the well, and tension is happen in the top. And from outside casing, this mud weight and formation pressure, the formation pressure, the mud weight is less, there is a chance of collapse of the well is there. So from that, we design a casing. So, and we'll go more detailed in other one. So this is gives us some idea how casing is being designed, that is well designed. So in big company, there is a well design company who decide the mud viscosity, who decide the tripping speed, who decide the swabbing speed, who decide the what should be casing design pressure, what is the depth of the casing based on the pore pressure and fracture pressure. There should not be any regression in the well. There are in JSPC around 4,000 feet. 4,000 meter, there was a regression, so we have a differential stuck up a lot of there. So from this, we can also get some idea with the formation pressure and get some idea about what should be the optimum casing size in the bottom, whether it is a 5.5-inch casing or it should be a 9.58 or 7-inch liner, what should be there. So from the AP, the deviated well, so we had to put other tool also, other than one LWD, MWD deviation tool or directional tool has to be, RSS tool has to be lowered, rotary scalable tool we call it. Measurement while drilling is different, and LWD is a different, LWD is a logging while measurement. So from that we do CCL and VDL. CCL is a casing, both casing and cement evaluation. So nowadays new tool has come, so who can give the evaluation of both bonding of both cement with formation and casing. So new logging has come. So this gives the idea of whether in behind the casing the cement is there or not. So putting a brick plug, or then we have to go for squeeze cementation. So perforation phasing out either 180 degree, 120 degree or 90 degree each on fracture, horizontal or vertical. Vertical fracture not all desired for any well, but sometimes angular fracture happen, but that were not sustained for long time. So how many fractures? Suppose there are probable zones are there, 11 zones are there. You saw that there is a possibility of good permeability or saturation is there. So we may select 6 zones. That has to be done with a consultant based on the log analysis data. And the reservoir rock is acid soluble or not. Acid soluble should be there, but it should be avoided. When acid soluble, but it cannot be fully avoided because sometimes of calcium and equivalent is are there which get acid salt. So effect on acid on propane, otherwise if they put acid and propane get dissolved at the age get on, there still the embedment will be there. So now I'm coming to new subject. We have faced a huge problem with barium chloride mud. It is a toxic and it was required more basic gravity is there. So Schlumberger research group, they find out a going again research project at the RAF mart. So they crossed it to almost one mark on side. And from the right side car, there are three types of mud for these guys. API 75 micron top side, another API 25 micron is on, that's called a RAF mud. So here the sag potential of RAF mud is drastically reduced, which makes the well more secure. But you try to understand it, when it keeps a well for running in or pulling out, or you pull out for changing the bits, or that's called tripping, or you're changing the stabilizer, or changing the, because after every 4th or 5th day, the MWW tool has to take it out and do some checking or servicing, because high temperature well required it. That process mud stays in the well. So when drill string enter in the well, that due to thixotropic property, gel stain, so it we have to circulate after lowering every 10 drill pipe. But in RAF mud doesn't happen. You can directly go. That rheological property of the viscosity and centrifuge and other value doesn't get gel stain or doesn't get changed. So there's one thing. And there is invasion is very less. RAF mud is a very small, 1 micron particle is there. Bentonite is there. So it's good for very high temperature, high pressure well. Very low viscosity is also there. Particle size is very small. Efficient solid separation at the surface. So another point is that limitation of tool. When you are done the job this time, there is no tool available at such a high temperature. So 173 degree LWD, MWD, other drill string tools are there. So at static condition, that goes up about 10 to 15 degrees temperature when stopping for making a connection. So there is a flow get stopped. That creates a lot of problem. There are for high temperature, high pressure well, because mud is very thixotropic mud that there, it gets gel. And so RAF mud has helped a lot. Do sensor accuracy, because sensor accuracy means temperature sensors are there in the system. So accuracy should be that. So I'll come next page. So because what they do to high temperature is more than 180 degrees centigrade, there will be temperature shocking. So in one of the well ST, when circulation temperature is plotted here, temperature has gone up to 175 degrees centigrade at depth of 4,500 to 4,800 meters. So it has been observed due to high temperature, shock of the tool fails and prematurely. So most time we pull it out, printed circuit PLC logic, we check it, but we found that the capacitor is getting burnt out. So then we tell the manager to change the tool, but they say that will take more time to import this thing. So what we will do, I'll come next time. So critical staging procedure have been designed to cool down the tool. So we take out the tool and cool down for some time, and we have certain hours are there to take to cool down both MWD and W tools in order to avoid temperature shock. In temperature shock, some of the programmable logic circuit, any controller have a three card. One is a PLC type control is there. One is input card, another is output card, another is a process card. So a PLC is called. So just like in old days we have a radio. So LC circuit, large circuit is there when the small chips are there, just like mobile here. So where temperature dissipation should be such that it should not get damaged. So a lot of quality control and quality check is there. So for server, there should be a standby tool also in the surface. And then cable gets swell. At this high temperature, the first cable will get swell. So you have to give some time to hold it. When they get in sync, then you go ahead. So cooling time should be considered. And in the surface, there should be mud cooler is also should be there. We have used it everywhere in GSPC work. So, before using RAF mud, we used to have a differential stocking. So, to prevent that one, In the reservoir section, we use a heavyweight drill collar instead of heavyweight. We use a heavyweight drill pipe instead of drill collar. So it would have been avoided with the spiral drill collar, but we have avoided drill collar because space between annulus in the hole and drill collar is less. So circulation pressure goes up in the mud pump. So optimize the mud weight balance minimum differential pressure. So used to drill about 0.3 differential pressure to drill the well. When 0.2 is there, we have to be very careful. It is very careful, very, very careful. Again, condition the mud and check the rheological property, viscosity, temperature, and other weight. Basic habitats to check it. And we have to add some fluid loss control in that condition also. Sometimes they'll get break and fluid loss control is not there. So there is a filtration will be there, so differential stocking will be there. So this is one of the well where regression is there in the pore pressure, is that bottom portion of it. So due to regression, then we have to, suppose we use mud about 1.65 or 1.6, then we have to reduce the mud weight. If we reduce the mud weight, there is a kick will be there, the blot will be there. So this wrap mud also will help us to manage that thing. So we could drill it at 0.2 differential pressure, PPG. So generally it's 16.5 PPG, so then mud weight will be 0.7. So when you stop circulating, making a broken joint, the viscosity and pressure gravity would increase also. So differential stuck up, we should four wells we have a differential stuck up, and all the four wells have to start tracking. So risk challenges mitigation measures. So this is the HPT tool. We have already told you that mud cooler, temperature control, cooling, and cable to give a rest, and high temperature in my static period should be more than that. Means when you're holding the things for 30 minutes, so that time you should maintain it so that our temperature goes down. Now we don't need it because we record it tool more than 200 degree Fahrenheit, so we're able to do this all job without this UAQC control much. So we had also once blowout, but we could control it because we could run we had some small expansion tank is there. When the flow back is there, we could locate, understand there is a blowout is there inside. So there are five methods are there to blow out, to detect or to control. One of these driller method, another is the direct method, another wait and watch method. So there are also technical methods are also there. So, to stabilize the avoid the control, the pre-drill geomechanics being performed by third party to predict it. So, third party risks, metrics audits should be there before starting any deep water or high temperature well or many well more than 3000 meter, 500 meter well. So, that third party has to be done. So after doing wrap mud, our pressure gravity mud came down to 16.5 to 15.3 and 15.6. So we were able to establish a procedure to how to take out the drill string without any interruption. We continuously pump it, some mud gets lost in the system. We also able to manage the ballooning and wellbore effect during the well control situation. So eliminate the use of water-based mud and sacrificial mud in reservoir section, and avoid barite sagging, so use wrap mud. Mainly the beauty of the GSPC well that we used to have the drill bit. They used to drill ROP was only 1 meter per hour, so it was very bad, very bad. So we could change the bit. I'll come in a bit, we'll tell you. So change the bit and more stabilizer that they are used it in the string to make the whole bit on weight should be more. So reservoir section at 4,500 to 5,000 meter true depth. Compressive strength of the rock is 10 to 25 psi, which is sting goes up to 30 PSI sometimes. So the mitigation process we have taken. So we should not go drip because go beyond this drip, we could not control it. And moreover, there is a permeability variation too much is there. So we process a different challenge. So you know, sticking of drill pipe angle is more in open hole. If you go that one without putting hoistock and other things, it will problem. So we change the bit design also. We are cutting angle and spiral gauging also. So this is the two types of bit we use it, 5, 7, 8 bits, another is 12 3/4 bolt. They used to drill something around 800 meters, so we gone up to 1800 meters. And we could drill up to almost 5 to 6 days. I used to have only every third day we should have tripping. So any tripping progress which goes down and there is a risk of money stuck up, differential stuck up is there when pulling it out. So this is the ROP comparison. So we can see that ROP is the maximum which is maintaining between 2 and 3. In the black portion, you can see 4,000 to 4,900 meters. So this is the casing design. Basically, here is a 20-inch surface casing, then 13.38 intermediate casing, 9.58 production casing, and 7-inch production tieback is there, and 4.5-inch tubing is here. So different annular portion. There is a formula is here. There are two forces that goes up when casing is going to set. What is happening in casing? Basically, on tensile load, one is bus pressure in the bottom, another is compressive load. These are the three pressures are there. So based on the casing, different Young's modulus and formula and welded expansion is there. So the expansion has to be controlled in such a way the cement height behind the casing has to be such that empty space should be less. So empty space has to be such a way that because it is desirable to the cement should come to the surface. But in case of liner, it is not possible. So we have changed the casing design in the next well, and we casing design changing, so we could hang the internal intermediate casing, 9.58 casing to up to surface. So these are the selection of tubing process based on the how much liquid has to be flow and how much you have to rate, and based on the how much wellhead separator pressure, suppose separator pressure is 50 degree, wellhead pressure should be 20. This is the rule of thumb. 50 pressure will be 100 minimum. But if it's more than that, but after choke has to be designed in such a fashion. So that my pressure should be maintained, so that flow will be long. So generally, the rule of thumb is there. About 70 cubic meters of fluid is the flow. So then, at surface pressure is, wellhead pressure is 1000 PSI pressure. So it is better to have a 3.5-inch tubing. So these are the high temperature pressure. One is a permanent packer and one is a retrieval packer. Retrieval packer during fracturing process sometimes get unseated. There is a drillable packer, there is a retrieval packer. There is a permanent packer, there is a retrieval packer. So permanent packers are set by explosive weld line or maybe mechanical setting tool. But has to be drilled. So bridge plug are generally permanent packer, but very rarely for completion we use permanent packer. So there we use a polished bore receptacle, PBR. So in the polished bore is there, where the tubing goes and the both side packing is there. When you come, I'll show you. So permanent packer need to be milled after removal. And go for another zone fracturing or another doing workover, we have to drill. So two types of tubing and thermal effect they are under the anchor tubing, another is polished bore resistable. Here is polished bore resistable, you can able to see it. Most of the packers set and by compression pressure. So the ratchet moves inside, the yellow color ratchet moves inside, compress the black one, and so store the Energy and Packard get held that position. In a ritual packer, either in the pickup, direct pickup, or by rotation, it can be picked up. So anchor packer is desirable because they know doing so much pressure in the tubing for during fracturing. So ballooning and reverse ballooning is happening. After fracture is over, the balloon is over ballooning time. When fluid coming back, and reverse ballooning is happening. So when if you anchor the packer, so there is a less chance of fracture movement in the system. But whereas PBR, there is a chance of movement and the seal, rubber seal in the packing that get leakage in the high pressure, sometimes due to high temperature also. So anchored tubing generally, different school of thought, what our consultant also studied it in the lab and they found it for our well, previous we used to have hydraulic packer. So we go for many anchor packer, but later on we decided we could go for hydraulic permanent packer, which need not to be retrieved time, but we can cut it and drill day when you go for it. So tubing string was 3.5 inch, 12.7 austenitic steel. When austenitic steel is a chrome steel, 24 chrome steel. Because we have a, after 3 months flowing there, we have a both stress corrosion in tubing. IIT Bombay, their metallurgical section studied it and said that we go for 22 chrome to 35 chrome. And perforation for 3SP, short per mini, 18S perforation, this is a slumberer one. Wildline gun, we have used it. Size is gun size is 2.25 inches. To get 20 effective perforation as per SRT test, you don't get isolated and leak up rate is 16 to 12 psi per minute. The prefactor test is a mini frac basically, is a pressure dependent leak up test is there. Observe the permeability is in line with not petrophysical property. So this is the money operation of well completion sequence. Lowering the 8.5 opener, then running 7-inch liner and cementing the job. Then running this 7.58 into 7-inch production tieback system. Then run upper completion. Then frac and isolation selection zone. Then clean out the propane. Then flow back the well, flowing the well in the inside the tubing. These are the different types of frac job we carried out. There is different starting pressure there. We have done is Miller dives, Hornets meters of pressure build up, data T by T. A long paper, semi-long one. So fluid tap is a linear gel, zero comat. So propane type was 700 pounds, 40 by 70 Saudi sand. And another Garbo HSP, this is a synthetic one. This is a combination of 80 to 20. We have used it after failure of job. We have decided that one. The Hornets permittivity could not be estimated properly, but it was a limited reservoir, so it could not find it is unlimited.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you, but please, sir, try to complete presentation by 4, as we have another webinar at 4.
Okay.
Okay.
So I'll go for 2 slides then. Okay. The type of frac model is a different theory as there. PNK model long and limit the height and elliptical vertical cross section what you saw earlier. Then KGD models are wide calculation, so basically is height independent, short fracture. Radial model grow growth fracture at point it create from point source. Planar 3D model and pseudo 3D model. How different parameters are affecting the fracture growth and the propagation and assumption of simple lump pseudo 3D model and cell based pseudo 3D model. And then we have to do leak process, then pre-pack job, different pre-pack job, characteristics of job. So SDID stiffness test is there, follow up test is there. Then what is the diagnostic fracture initiation test is there, because when the fracture permittivity was your 0.01 to 0.5 PSI resolution surface gauge, used it for fracture permittivity was 0.18. So because these are the G function. From G function we can explain it little here. So these are the top portion is the breakdown pressure, and then bottom one crushing pressure, then shut-in pressure, then frac pressure, then reservoir part pressure, different flow pressures are there. So these are the during fracturing process different dwellet temperature, proper treating pressure, bottom one treating pressure, pumping rate, surface measurement is there. Then flow back the fracturing fluid sand needs to be monitored at a regular interval, the flow back period. And BSNW 1% measurement of piping thickness is done, because we had accident during tubing got eroded. And backflow fracturing fluid should be diverted after it gets less than 1 BSNW to process system. So these are the vertical multiplex separator. This is the horizontal multiplex separator. Key improvement is that higher rate is possible of treating the additional zone, number of counters. So we got ability to get accurate by DFLT for each zone. So this is the last one. Thank you very much.
Okay, sir. So there are many questions from our student. So my first question is, which software are mostly used in modeling of hydraulic fracturing in gas reservoirs?
So that is very associated, very, very I told you not. These are the software, different software is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we are PNK model, we use it for very associated factor simulation model. The software we have used it.
Okay. Sir, second question is fracture propagation is exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction?
It creates a temperature.
Pardon, sir?
It is not isothermic. It is adiabatic.
Okay. Yes, sir. My third question is, what are the most effective parameters on hydraulic fracturing treatment?
Parameter, you should have a proper fluid selection. You should have a petrophysical study. From petrophysical study, you should know the geomechanics of the rocks and porosity permeability rocks. And before starting the fracture, you should have a mini frac job. And you should have a more capacity of pumping. In onshore, in ONGC and Oil India, they do 2 GPM fracturing, maximum 4 GPM, gallons per minute. Whereas these fracture jobs are very high rate fracture. 20 to 28 ppm, so about 6 pumps are here used. So at a time, this is all totally computer online monitoring is there. Any pump goes funk or anything goes wrong, he able to detect it. And if nowadays technology has come up, if fracture fails, we can start again. So the technology has come, we have done it well number 4 in GSPC.
Okay, sir.
So you should be very careful and flow back the well. So you should not increase the choke side or decrease the choke side. So you should use 1/64 of inch of a choke increasing every 8 to 10 hours. Not less than time, not more than inches side. 1/64 side. Then you will get a success in the system.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I would like to thank you for your valuable time, and I look forward to our next meeting. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, madam. So nice of you. Okay.
Okay, sir.